generally the average weight when normal children, when they are born after full pregnancy, so average weight should be minimum of about 3 kilos, 2.5 kilos, 3 kilos on average, immediately after birth. But these children always have underweight, less weight and less growth also. Even the growth of the child is less than the normal. And even after birth, during the development also, these children of this miasm are generally weak. They are weak and more susceptible also. Even from the very childhood, this miasm makes the child very susceptible from the very beginning. So the rate of susceptibility is more in children of this miasm than the other miasms. Because this miasm, this tubercular miasm, is an intense miasm. That is why you find more and more children are susceptible in spite of so many methods of prevention, vaccinations. Nowadays, so many things are applied for children, even during pregnancy. But that doesn't help anyway because of this miasm. Because they have inherited this miasm from the parent, are disturbed in many ways during sleep, and even when they are awake also, even during sleep also. And the development of the fetus during pregnancy, even the development of the fetus and the position of the fetus, there are many sorts of distortions caused by this miasm. So nowadays you see more and more cases of distortions in the development of the fetus. So the position of the fetus and also all this is caused mostly by this miasm. In the case of other miasms, if it is psoric miasm and psychotic miasm, those miasms, there also disturbance is there, but after the birth and then gradually when the child is growing, so this manifestations increase. But in this miasm, the manifestation starts. This is because the parents, already there is the on the inner levels of consciousness, on the higher layers, mental and higher layers, are very much occupied and already in the advanced degree. And then when the conception takes place, so this makes its effect immediately. That is why right from that time, as we have studied earlier, any miasm, it makes the person, it distorts the mental behavior of the person. So therefore the action of the person is distorted automatically by wrong actions. And the consequences of the wrong action increases. So it is like a vicious thing. The miasm gets more intensified with every wrong thinking and wrong action. So that is how the miasm makes the person, because it increases its influence more and more. So that is why from the very time of conception and during pregnancy, you have so many problems. And then with the medication, the problem increases, because the medication what we apply is always without any similarity. That's what we have seen. When we apply any medicine without having a similarity of nature, then the disease gets intensified. That is what is proved very clearly. So the manifestation may be suppressed, but the disease, this is we have to understand very clearly. By applying any medication without similarity, that particular manifestation of the disease may be suppressed or made to disappear, but the disease as such is intensified. This we have to always remember. This is clearly we have to understand. So when the disease gets intensified, so that it can make another manifestation, because you have suppressed one manifestation. That's what is happening even during pregnancy also. That is why most of the women during pregnancy, when they consume more medicines, that makes the problem much worse. So the miasm gets stronger during the development of the fetus. That is what is happening. And another feature of this persons of this miasm is that they cannot. You have any question? To suppress. Generally, it makes its manifestation, and when you apply suppressive type of treatments, then it gets much stronger. If the herbs are only those type of herbs which can strengthen your vital force without creating any secondary action, then it is okay. But if they create any secondary action, then the secondary action, that means the substance, even though it is a herb, it may produce a secondary, if it can produce a secondary action, that means it has a capacity to bring a disturbance. So if there is similarity, it will cure automatically. This is how we have to understand. We must know the nature of the herb. So some herbs are like the food substance, they will only strengthen the vital force. So they are okay. But some are really medicinal and poisonous capacity. That means poisonous means which can produce intense secondary action, the vital force. So there we must be careful. There we have to observe whether it is needed with similarity or not, that we have to observe. So we cannot go on blindly or just generalizing in the case of so many substances. We have to know the nature of this before we use it. So another feature of this miasm is that they are very sensitive to cool climate. So they cannot bear, they are chilly persons in this miasm. Sensitive to cool climate, cool breeze, cool applications. That is a general feature of this. So these are the persons who are much quickly affected during the change of the climates from warm to cold climates. Some are very sensitive, hypersensitive, and some are less, but it is general nature of this miasm. So these patients, the first reaction is that whenever there is, let me start a reaction. It is also there in psychotic miasm, but there it is more in this miasm. Some persons are so hyperactive, hypersensitive. For example, the patients who need natrum sulfur, so we can know when we can know from these persons that in a few days there is going to be a cyclone or a cold wave. So we don't know because it is not yet manifested, but they are like the remote sensors, the radars, like that. Already they start catching cold. So is such is the constitution of these persons. They will catch cold. First, for the first reaction is, it starts with cold symptoms. So with sneezing and wheezing and all these symptoms. And along with that, then following symptoms are headache or pains all over the body and all this.
Is that also the case of people who have pains in a certain part of the body, or for instance a bone that has been broken in a particular place, and then afterwards when it heals they can foretell whether it is changing because of this pain in the bone on the place where it was broken? Is that the same or not?
That is not the same. This is by nature, from the very beginning, from the constitution. So these persons, generally, the people of, the patients of this miasm, tubercular miasm, so whenever they happen to get exposed, suppose they have gone for a dip in a river or in the sea when it is cold, so invariably they are affected. So they catch a cold and that continues for a long time. And you find in these persons, in this tubercular miasm, that the disturbances appear in cyclic manner. That is also a very striking feature of this miasm. So first they catch cold. So it stays for 1 week, 2 weeks, like that, in spite of taking any medicine, but stays. And finally, somehow they could get rid of the cold. So when the cold has disappeared, then they start coughing. So for 1 or 2 weeks, coughing and coughing, and then they take some medication for coughing. And finally, the cough is controlled. So now they feel, now this cough is over. And then, when the cough is getting better, then they get fever. And a few days with fever. And then, some medication, some treatment for fever. And then finally, fever is under control. And then they cannot breathe. And when the fever is controlled, then they get constipated. So then for a few weeks. They have to make something for this constipation. So finally, you feel, now the constipation is over. And they are little bit, they can feel happy. But then because they have taken some medicine for constipation, and constipation is better, then it gets into diarrhea. Then some medication, some treatment for diarrhea, and somehow with great difficulty, diarrhea is controlled. And when they get diarrhea stops, then they get headaches. And it takes again a few days before the headache is controlled. And so it is, has taken a few weeks, 5 weeks, 6 weeks, like that. And then got rid of the headache, and then again they catch cold. Another cycle. So always when you observe this person, something or other will be bothering. Even when there is no serious acute condition, but these conditions are regular. Never you can see this person totally free from anything. That is why very regularly these persons are under medication. Because one of these ailments, one after another, in a very cyclic manner. So the cycle is not broken, it continues. Unless you do something to neutralize this miasm, to decrease the intensity of the miasm, you have to apply a remedy with similarity which can cut this cycle, this miasm. Otherwise, and then with this cyclic order, what happens? More and more they get more susceptible, and then suddenly they get into some dangerous conditions, because their body is already susceptible to all this. And then if there is an epidemic anywhere, first these are the people immediately they invite this into the constitution. Yes. And then another indication, another feature of this miasm is a tendency, frequently most of these people have a tendency for epistaxis, bleeding from the nose. Without any apparent reason, suddenly he gets bleeding from the nose. Why? There is no particular reason. He starts suddenly to bleed. This is more in Chupakul miasm than in Sora. In Sora also you have this tendency, but tubercular, especially tubercular children, very often they start bleeding from the nose. And then adamant behavior. So they have no respect. These people, they have no respect for elders and also no respect for anybody. With anybody they can behave in a such a manner, harsh and adamant behavior. So the children of this tubercular miasm, when they are growing in age, already when they are in little bit growing, 10 years for example, already this child cannot be easy, because if the parent says something, he can immediately say no, or if the parent tries to punish, he can retort. So this nature increases more in these persons. So very adamant nature right from the childhood. So the same thing continues, because when they are put into school, there will be problem with the teachers, because they behave in the same manner with the teachers also. They want to do what they like in the class. If the teacher wants to control, then they will retort. Many children now. That is why many children are with tubercular miasm now. And they do very dangerous things. You know, from time to time, in the news you see, in the US, especially this, you can observe this tubercular miasm has intensified from the United States, because the behavior, from time to time in the news you see a little fellow takes a gun, and last year or somewhere I have observed in the news, because the teacher was harsh, and then next day he brought the gun and shot the teacher. Finish. Yes, that is. It is increasing more. In India, very stray incidents, not so many. But. Yes. No, if it is really a highly evolved soul which has come into incarnation, they will not behave in a miasmatic manner.
But Lord Krishna also was very naughty.
Naughty, that is naughty thing is different than destructive thing. He is not destructive. He only destroyed the demons, but not the good people. Play the games, yes. Play the games is without the child, because we must be able to discriminate between the normal naughty behavior of the child and abnormal behavior. Both are not the same. Yes. Yeah. It is only ignorant of these things.
But now nobody wants to control the children, because all of them are evil.
Yes. Let them do what they want to do. So that is indiscipline and this type of behavior. You have to make discrimination between what is the divine and what is the other diabolic and all this. Otherwise we confuse between these two.
But the consciousness of the parents is also distorted, because when the kids are doing some of these things which are obviously clearly not acceptable, but the parents say, oh, they are my children.
Yes.
People doing these unacceptable things.
Yes.
And the parents are,
yeah, because the children are like that because it is inheritance from the parents. The Chibrakla, so that is the because the from where they got, the children got this from the parents. So there is no proper understanding in the parents because of the miasm. When the parents are ill, and already by the time of conception, then the child cannot be healthy. If the parents were healthy at the time of conception, and only later after the birth of child, if there is due to some reason they are not sick, that is different. But the sickness, if it is on the mental level, that is not suddenly. That is already there since a long time. So if the parents are sick mentally, that the child will be affected. That is quite sure. That is what we are studying.
So there is no exception for this rule. Perhaps if you say that some great soul comes, she can overcome this miasma.
If it is really great soul coming down, then they will not come. They don't select miasmatic parents, because the selection, every soul has a choice to select, and the choice to select depends upon the influence from the previous birth. That is what we study from the scriptural sciences. So naturally, a soul which has such miasmatic influence before is attracted towards the miasmatic parents. If it is pure soul, a pure soul will select pure parents. Because in nature nothing is by chance. In nature everything is precise. The forces that are working in nature, they are not like human beings to make such mistakes. So these children who have inherited this miasm, they are so adamant that so they can get into quarrel often. They may get into argument and quarrel with the parents or with teachers or with any person in the society. So this quarrelsome nature and argumentative nature also is there in these children. And they get very impulsive. So the impulsive nature is high in these persons of this miasm. And then another very, very characteristic feature of this miasm, Chibrakla miasm, is indiscriminate career with sex, that is very characteristic feature of this miasm. So children who are born with advanced degree of this miasm, from the very beginning, from the childhood, you find this tendency of the sexual excitement, which is not natural at that age. So from the very childhood also, in some children you find this. And when they are growing up, this increases with their age. So they are very beastly in their sexual behavior. Very intense degree of this behavior about this, and beastly. So they don't follow any rules and norms about this sexuality. So they'll behave very aggressively also. So they have no, for these persons, they don't believe in regulations and rules about sexuality. Because their mind is so much conditioned and excited with this aspect. So therefore their behavior is distorted. So for these persons, there is no discrimination. There is no, in most indiscriminate, illogical type of sexual behavior. So even a young boy, for example, an young boy of 10 years also can have that type of thinking and that type of inclination, even with elders, adults. So this is unnatural. Because this exaggerated sexual instinct is what you find, especially in this miasm, very exaggerated. So all the time, every thought, every action, it goes around this aspect of sex. So when they read something, they like very much to read those things where you can find this indiscriminate sexual activities. When they see any pictures also, so the fellows who like very much inclination for nude pictures and all these, it is because of this miasm. A great inclination for that, a craving, an inclination, from the very early age. Because biologically, according to the natural sciences and biologically, it is at certain age for this. So the most ideal is only after 20s. When you cross 20 years, the need for and all this. But now you see, by the time of 20s, everything is finished. Because they get into this activity very early age, when they are 10 years old, and then they start. So what happens? They are exhausted, finished. Yes, because naturally the balance is lost. So the need biologically, according to the natural sciences, biologically, after 20 years and up to 50 years, that is the age where there is much as a need for this. But if it is below that and beyond that, that is not so natural. But for these persons, it is completely exaggerated in all, in a very early age and also beyond that age. Even they get very old, 80 years also, still they can feel like this, which is highly unnatural. So everything there, every aspect is around this. They can make everything around this. So this makes them behave in such a manner, what is called nymphomania. Some persons who are very tubercular, they get into this nymphomaniac behavior. So they want to have the sexual activity without the norms of age and all this. So a fellow of 50 years wants to have this with a girl of 10 years. It is absurd. All these types of distortions, this is due to the tubercular miasm. All the crimes, there are many types of sexual crimes, more and more increasing. And they have no norms. When this miasm increases in the person, no discipline and no norms. Always there is a tendency for variety about sex also.
It is an obsession,
a serious obsession. If they cannot get rid of this, then they will finally end into an incurable manifestation of incurable disease on the physical level. And that will be too late when it is not cured before. Because all this type of behavior that results into such manifestations. That is what is called the cosmopolitan behavior. We call it the cosmopolitan. Yes, that is what. So anybody can have with anybody. That's that. What is that? It is like animals, worse than animals. Because animals will have some time for that, but human beings have no time for that. Anytime, anywhere, anybody, that is cosmopolitan behavior. So definitely, that is the reason why diseases like AIDS are increasing. All these homosexualities and all these things are the distortions of this. All this is due to tubercular miasm. That is why Hahnemann and other Kent and other later doctors, they found, and Master also has explained so many dimensions of this tubercular miasm, how it is increasing more and more. When you compare it to a few decades ago. Now, it has more and more increased. That is why your number of cases of this incurable disease is increasing. AIDS is the best example for that. In every country, it's now increasing more and more. So that is one of the terrible manifestations of tubercular miasm. So there, because this, here in this aspect also, there is dissatisfaction that makes the person always. So this dissatisfaction, that is the underlying cause. That is why they get into such type of behavior. So they may get into the symptoms of the remedies like acid fluoric. So the person of acid fluoric constitution, it means on a high level of acid fluor, that person will wants to have sex always with a new partner. That is the tendency, always. There are many fellows increasing now, number is increasing of this such persons. That is high degree of tubercular miasm. Then what happens after some years, then the body will be completely distorted, because that is against law of nature. If the children are born, those children are in the worst degree of this miasm. Yes.
Does homosexuality cure neuropathy?
Yes. It can be cured if they want to get rid of this. Yes, it is. Yes, that is distortion. That is because of tubercular miasm. It is increasing everywhere around the world. Everywhere. We can try. But one thing, if after middle age, the possibility of cure is not so easy. If anything is to be done, better it is to start with early age. After certain age, after middle age, then it is not so easy.
But homosexuals, this is a deadline. They are not having children.
How can it is unnatural? How is it possible? It is completely.
So we have to clear things around.
No, if they allow to be treated, then you can cure from this.
This person's about the epidemiology, yes, of miasm, we cannot do something on the social level because of government strategy.
Yes, because this is a miasm on the level of government. That is why these fellows of the government have legalized this. That means they are crazy fellows.
But if this miasm is so high,
yes.
And afterwards they
those
children are there,
they
separate.
Yes, that is what is going on.
Yeah.
That is still worse. producing children of this high degree of this miasm, that is still worse, because already from the very childhood this will be distorted behavior. And that is what is happening more and more. Yes.
That is what's happening now also in Belgium.
Yes.
And these kids are getting adopted. That most of the time, these people, if they're men, for instance, they have very high positions because they're usually not interested in anything but money and the other partner. And then they accumulate a lot of money. And in fact, the reason why they can adopt in many cases is because they have a stable job and a big amount of money on their bank account so that they can ensure the future of the child. And the big problem is that there are real families with good hearts and man, woman, loving each other. They cannot have children and they want to adopt and they are not allowed by the government because they cannot ensure financially.
Ah, yes. Yes, that is terrible. That is terrible. That is the miasma of the government. That is very crazy. So all this type of fantasies about sex, that is what you find mostly in this miasm. Because mostly there it is fantasy. beyond the natural limit, it is all fantasy about this. So that creates many mental distortions and then manifested on the physical plane. That is what you see in many types of disturbances. So when this miasm gets intensified, then it manifests on the physical plane in the form of physical tuberculosis or in the form of AIDS, in all these diseases, cancer or AIDS or tuberculosis. All these are various manifestations on the physical body, which is almost a stage of coming to the end of the span. Because of this miasm, when it manifests on the physical body, the destruction of the physical tissue is much faster in this miasm than the other miasms.
Cancer can occur in all the miasms in different levels, right?
Yes, cancer can occur in any miasm. But cancer, when it happens with this miasm, is very fast and aggressive. Yes, very fatal. That is what you see. And also, persons of this miasm, after a certain time, may get into insanity. Insanity. Yes, Alzheimer is one of the manifestations of this mostly tubercular miasm and also syphilitic miasm. Parkinsonism, these are all various manifestations. So, persons of this miasm, the longevity is also decreased because the manifestation and on the physical plane is faster and fatal. So, the longevity is decreasing. And if you make with artificial means, if you just keep the person alive, because that's what you see. Now, they claim that now we have increased the span of life of people. But what is the use? They are in the old age homes and they are medicated just as well.
Yes. Yes.
Morphine,
yes.
Giving morphine.
And they even have a legal standard for it. In the Netherlands, for instance, it is allowed.
Yes,
it is allowed.
Even Belgium also has it.
No, Belgium. We still have trials to condemn doctors who try to help people to die. That's illegal. But in the Netherlands, it's legal.
Switzerland, okay. But still, it's okay.
Yeah, because I know the mother of Krish, she was given morphine.
Yeah. It is practiced, but it is illegal.
Yeah.
Since 2002,
Because it was only 3-4 years ago when I was there, then I have visited this lady, old lady, because she requested me to request her mother. So I went there. But the son of this old lady, the brother of Krish, he was telling that, oh, she wanted me to give some medicine to improve her. But he said, no, she should not be given anything. She should be given morphine because the doctor has promised. And finally they gave morphine and she's gone.
But he can start a legal court
case against her. But the son himself, he promoted this. So who will start the legal? So that is what is happening. So all this, so many things you find distortions. So these are some of the features which we have studied. So we have studied in this course about the miasm in brief. Because we have taken only a few features as an example for our study. So you can now, on this basis, when you study about these miasms, more and more you can understand. When you observe the cases and then make a study, then you can more and more understand about this miasm and how to treat the persons for this level of miasm. So this is the conclusion of our present session. With this we conclude our present session of study. And I wish you all a good continuation of the study of the subjects which we were studying together. Now I can say that we were studying together. I was also studying with you. Because it's a good advantage for me. Because as teachers, that means we are more and more enriched when we try to teach. So this is a good... Therefore, we express our thanks to all of you, because you have given a good opportunity to us once again to improve our area of knowing all this. And we will continue this study further. And may God bless you all. Master's blessings to all of you. Vasudeva. So this afternoon,